Well, hello YouTube channel, it's Belmont here. And for this week's video, I want to show some love and appreciation for Weiser locks. And this is your typical Weiser lock entry. And many types of motels use them. They are as effective as a quick set, and in fact, the keys for Weiser can often be interchangeable with quick set. So I do a lot of picking, and I am of the locksport community and will continue to be, even with my last dying breath. And I've been told by many people of the quote-unquote so-called locksport community that, Belmont, you're not part of the locksport community. Well, I've seen that many of the people of the so-called locksport community have in particular say they are no longer of it, or they no longer do lock sport. And some have actually trying to start selling memberships for, quote, the cost of a cup of coffee, or $4 to, quote, support the channel as they go into different endeavors of locksmithing and security aspects. Well, that's not going to get someone very far, that you pay, a stranger pays a person who puts his face on a screen, and for $4, they will give your name a shout out on their video. And that just seems retarded because, one, you're charging people just to get their name put out there. I do believe it's Starry Lock who gives shout-outs to many small and upcoming or small-time channels, and he puts their name out there. I don't hear about him charging people $4 to do that. So I think that's pretty fucked up, to be honest. Because if you have a job, that job you do, your 9-to-5 Joe job, should be what you use to supplement your income that you're putting into your YouTube videos. Anything less than that would be scummy. Also, I don't charge people to say their name in a video. I'm more than glad to give someone a shout out in a video, mention their name or whatever. I have also never charged people once for the things I've done for them in the past. And I'll admit, during the first 2 years of the pandemic, I invested a lot of time in helping other people who were trying to get into it. And I searched down a lot of hours in trying to find them tools for a cheap and cost-effective price. I have helped 20 or 30 people with that information. And out of those 20 or 30, only two people actually asked me, is there something they could do for me in return to say thanks? And I said, yeah. One person I asked to get a hold of a cheap, used American lock in the 1100 series so I could have a go at learning how to pick it. Another, I asked if they could buy a cheap little credit card picking set off of Amazon, which was a pretty much a clone of the Sparrow's Chaos card, which was only $5 at the time, but can no longer be found on Amazon or eBay, actually. And I've helped my community. I've helped the local business by extracting a broken key and picking open three locks. And I didn't charge that owner a single penny. He wanted to pay me for my time, but I told him that would be unfair to him and asked, well, how about store credit? That way it's fair to both of us. And we shook on it. So that's just the kind of person I am. I'm also aware that when I put my information from my videos and other little tidbits of lock picking out there to one, the locksport community, and even the prepping and survival communities, yes, I am aware that a multitude of people will look at those videos and information. Some of them, for all intents and purposes, may have nefarious purposes in wanting to gain that information. But I put the information out there because not everyone knows. And those that actually do want to learn something new, it helps them gain a new skill as a whole. And as a member of the locksport community, I have also raised up another level. And I'm now ranked number 14 on the locksport top 40 channels to view in 2022. So I'm number 14 now instead of 15. And I'm quite proud of that. And I will continue to help my community, to help people, to educate others free of charge, because that's what makes a difference. So I want to thank my viewers. I want to thank my new subscribers for joining. Your names are not known to me, but the numbers are. I also get comments from a locksmith in Texas, and I have reached out to him, and I don't really hear anything back from him. So he did say he wanted to talk to me before, but I've put my info out there and heard nothing back. Oh well. So that's going to be all for this Friday on a warm day in the 60s here in western Pennsylvania. And as always, this is Belmont saying, stick around.